Hello, namaste, and welcome to a 9 p.m. primetime show. Hope you're safe and keeping well. This is your host, Arsh. As a part of our series on organizations that are making a mark on today's world, we have Ms. Isha Agar and Ms. Mehen Manga from Enactus Ashoka. Enactus as an organization has a vision to make the world more sustainable, and today we plan to learn more about Enactus Ashoka and their journey. Welcome both. So let us begin by talking about the inception of Enactus Ashoka. How did it all start? What was the motive behind such an initiative?
Thank you so much for having us. Enactus Ashoka was born a little over 2 years ago and is a part of the world's largest experiential learning platform. This platform helps us use techniques of social entrepreneurship with a vision to create and implement sustainable business models to accelerate growth and development. Our journey began with the initiation of Project Lakeed in 2018. Under this project, we began by meeting handcrafted diaries and provided vocational training to underprivileged women to enhance their skills and increase the economic opportunities available to them.
That sounds really interesting. So tell me something. Apart from empowering these women and helping them find a voice in the society, does your project also have an impact on the environment?
As you rightly said, we are mainly tackling a social issue of women empowerment. However, our approach to the same also includes us being conscious of our environment. A few ways in which we try to preserve the environment is by using the cotton cloth, which in turn reduces our carbon footprint. As you may have heard of Greta Thunberg, a true champion of climate change, we too at Lakeed try to reduce our carbon emission by encouraging members of our team to use the metro for their visits to the center. Lastly, at Project Lakeed, we don't package our products to avoid using harmful materials like plastic.
Welcome back after that short break. Continuing from our previous discussion, as you may be aware about the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals that believes in making a sustainable future by 2030, could you please tell us how do your projects cover some of them? Because what it seems like right now is that some of the SDGs that your project is covering is poverty and inequality. Could you please tell us what are the others?
As you rightly mentioned, poverty and gender inequality are the key sustainable development goals that we work with. Apart from those, we also cover economic growth, reduced inequalities, responsible consumption and production, and partnership for the goals. By helping the women become financially independent and self-reliant, we are trying to reduce the inequalities which are very prevalent in society today. We have also partnered with Lex Alliance Foundation, a non-profit organization, to extend our reach to as many underprivileged women as we can. As Lakeed continues to grow, we aim to achieve as many UN SDGs as we can.
Let's talk about the current situation. In lieu of the pandemic, it must have been difficult to continue production under Project Lakeed, right? So how are you dealing with the situation? Could you tell our viewers how Enactus, an organization that seems like providing a hands-on experience, is operating now?
Well, the pandemic was very hard for us as we had a lot of plans to expand Lakeed over the summer. However, while we could not continue with the production under Project Lakeed due to safety reasons, of course, we were determined to do something to help those in distress. Hence, we launched 3 fundraisers and raised around rupees 4 lakhs to help those affected due to the pandemic.
Oh, that sounds really enterprising. Could you elaborate on it?
Sure. So, Mr. Arsh, do you know that there are 40 million migrant workers struggling to go home? And the very highway that we take to college itself is flooded with migrant workers without shelter or food, just struggling to reach home. Our Project Sahyog was an attempt to bring together different Enactus organizations to partner up to achieve our common goal of making the world a better place. So our primary partner was Digital Empowerment Foundation, and we partnered with Enactus Jindal Global University, Enactus ADGITM, and raised more than rupees 2 lakhs for the migrant workers. Previously, we collaborated with HelpAge India to raise funds for essential goods for migrant workers under our project Milab. Recently, we've launched our newest campaign, Riddhi, that aims to promote menstrual hygiene among female migrant workers.
Thank you, Ms. Mehar, for answering my question in such detail. What I'm still not able to wrap my head around is, why couldn't you simply donate the funds that you collected to a scheme like the PM Care, or probably to some other organization that's already working in such a field? What was so different about your campaigns, and in particular Project Riddhi? You haven't really spoken about it.
Sure. So Mr. Arsh, you yourself tell me, whenever we see the news or even read the newspapers, the projected image is of a male migrant worker who is affected by the lockdown. And the main problem that most of these funds are tackling is either food or shelter or the loss of jobs. But what about the thousands of females who have no access to menstrual hygiene products due to the lockdown? Thus, the project that we have launched recently, Project Riddhi, addresses this very issue. Do you know that the funds that we have collected will help 1,000 women in Jharkhand and Maharashtra? We've collaborated with the Binjai Institute for Research Study and Action, as well as Kavach, a non-profit organization, who will distribute these kits in Jharkhand and Mumbai, respectively. Further, keeping in mind Inactus's goal of social entrepreneurship, we are also planning to collaborate with a community of women who are known for making chappals in Chembur in Maharashtra. And these women will be the ones who will be producing these kits, which will then be distributed to among the migrant workers.
So tell me something, as they say, this is the new normal. What are Inactus Ashoka's future plans?
As you said, the world has become virtual, so why not Project Lakir? Production under Lakir has begun in a new way where we use videos and calls to help and teach Aditi. We have also diversified into the production of new products, and a recent addition to that has been that of masks. As Project Lakir grows and becomes bigger, we aim to achieve 100% recyclability and sustainability, and we constantly work to uphold the Inactus vision of creating a sustainable world.
That is so great to hear. I hope Inactus Ashoka achieves great heights. Thank you so much for coming out tonight and speaking to me. It was a pleasure. This is your host, Arsh, signing off. Till then, keep safe and take care. Goodbye. Thank you. Thank you.